any longer.
Musani ke ukuthatha isimilo
to the pattern of this world.
Sabantu beliphakade.
But be transformed.
God, ingqondo zethu maziguquke.
Can you all say transform?
Sonke masithi ziguquke.
Can you all say transform?
Sonke sithi ziguquke.
Now Paul is saying be ye transformed.
Uthi kuPaulosi guqukani.
What is transformation?
Uthetha ukuthini ukuguquka?
Transformation is a dramatic change.
Lutshintsho lubonakalayo
in form and character.
Kwisimo nakwisimilo.
Transformation is a dramatic change in the form of a person and in the character of a person. Now Paul is addressing the church in Rome. He says, here is an advice to you. If you want to enjoy a dramatic change, this is how you will enjoy it. How will we enjoy it? By the renewing of your mind. Yes. He says, be ye transformed. How?
Jani.
By the renewing of your mind. By the renewing of your mind. Because the battle is won and lost in the mind. We win and we lose our battle, even our faith battle in the mind. There is a scripture in the book of
Hosea,
which I will be talking about in the weeks to come. In chapter 4, verse
6,
it says, my people perish through lack of knowledge. My people perish through the lack of knowledge. Where does knowledge sit? In the mind. And the Lord says, my people are perishing because they are sick. They are attacked in the mind. Hallelujah.
Glory to Jesus.
That's why you must watch your mind. That's why you must protect your mind. You see, you cannot choose or dictate which birds will fly over your head. Or whether birds will fly over your head. But you can determine whether they are going to make a nest over your head. Amen.
Hallelujah.
You cannot determine whether they are going to fly or not. That is out of your reach. But one thing you can do,
God,
as a
person,
you can determine whether they are going to put a nest on my head.
In other
words, there are so many things that are going to be said. But as a person,
God,
you have the right to determine what is going to get into your mind. That's why there are things you must embrace, and there are things you must reject, because once they make a nest on your head, you are
in big trouble.
Amen.
Hallelujah.
The mind, a very critical element in the life of a person. Change your mind. Change your thinking. And change your life. Hallelujah.
Glory to Jesus.
Our thinking affects our actions. Our reactions. Our expressions. The way of mind that you have will affect how you react to actions against you. The way you react. The way you express yourself. The way you conduct yourself.
It's
going to be influenced by your mindset. Hallelujah.
Glory to Jesus.
Your mind is very powerful.
Powerful.
I want you to understand. When you think right, you live right. When you think wrong, you will live wrong. It is set. It's cast on concrete. It cannot be changed. Now the Bible says, be ye transformed by the renewal of the mind. Simply put, change your mind. Change your everything. Now, when you become a child of God, you cannot think the way you used to think in the world. The world has a pattern of thinking, and the church has its own pattern of thinking. The way we used to act when we were coming against certain things in the world changes when we were in church. This is what Paul is talking about. He says, now that you are here, renew the mind. Change your thinking. Now, what do we need as children of God to renew our minds? I'm sure we all know it. Number one, we need the Word of God. The Word of God will renew and will rewrite the Word of the world. Because the world wrote in our minds. The world writes on your mind. The world writes on the mind of a married man that is not saved. There are certain things that become acceptable in the world. They are written by the world. But now when you come to church, the Word of God rewrites and erases what was written by the Word. The problem we have, we've got people in the church who have not erased the writing of the Word. They are saved. They love the Lord. The ink of the world is still glaring and vivid in their mind. Now, how do you delete it? By the renewal of the mind, by the Word of God. Ask your neighbor if you are still here. Hallelujah.
Glory to Jesus.
Hallelujah.
Hallelujah.
You see, when we allow the Word of God to guide us, to influence us, to govern our visions, to govern our values, then our lives change. They become better. Our circumstances become better. But now the Lord, when I was looking into this, preparing this, he brought something very interesting. The Holy Spirit said, most of my children do not possess renewed minds by the Word of God simply because they do not possess a teachable spirit.
You make me happy. You make me whole. You take the pain away. I'm so in love with you. You make me happy. You make me whole. You take the pain away. I'm so in love with you.